If you're a dairy farmer, you may want to stop right here and watch something else. You see, the milk industry as we know it is nearing an almost certain collapse. Kind of depressing for those dairy farmers, but there's no use crying over spilt milk. Wait till you see what's replacing it. This is the Flexitarian Times, and I'm Vince Werner. Got milk? Even if you don't currently have a carton of 2% in your fridge, or you're not a hardcore vegan, you probably do. Milk from cows finds its way into more products than you can imagine. But it's all on the verge of being replaced. And once it is, the only thing left of the industrial dairy industry will be quaint milking demonstrations at the county fair, right between the blacksmith and the glass blowing booth. I know, that sounds like an extreme prediction, but there are a lot of things coming together at this particular point in history that make that outcome seem pretty likely. Let's break it down. Okay, the first part of the equation. The dairy industry in 2020 is already on the ropes. It often costs more to produce a gallon of milk than what it sells for, and grocery stores often sell it at a loss to bring in customers to buy more profitable items. And so the whole industry is propped up by government subsidies. To make matters worse, the last decade has seen a huge decline in people drinking milk or pouring it on their Wheaties. They've turned to soy, almond, and other non-dairy alternatives for various reasons. And the less these grown-ups drink milk, the less their kids will drink milk, and so the downward spiral continues. But let's say for the sake of argument that drinking milk suddenly becomes cool again, and the decline in milk drinking stops right where it is and it doesn't get any worse. Yeah, that's not going to change anything. It'll still be time to put the dairy industry out to pasture. Here's why. Only 65% of dairy industry revenue comes from direct consumption. That means things like milk, cheese, yogurt, and of course ice cream. The other 35% is stuff like the proteins whey and casein that make their way into cake mixes, baby formula, sports supplements, and countless other products. Now that brings us to the second part of the equation. We're only a couple of years away from that 35% being replaced by something better, cheaper, and more environmentally sustainable. What's going to replace it, you say? Well, if you haven't seen my video on precision fermentation, you may want to just pause right here and give it a look-see. But in a nutshell, precision fermentation is the process of engineering microbes to create very specific organic molecules on demand instead of using the digestive systems of animals to do it. And proteins, fats, and sugars like those found in cow milk, they're really the low-hanging fruit of precision fermentation. It's not that hard, and it's already happening. I'll come back to that in a second. But first, in order to better understand the problem the dairy industry is facing, let's take a look at a bottle of whole milk and see what's all in there. It should come as no surprise that it's nearly 90% water. Roughly 5% is sugar in the form of lactose, 3.5% is fat, and there's less than 1% that's vitamins and minerals. That leaves only 3.3% for the protein in the form of casein and whey. So basically, you don't even have to disrupt the whole bottle of milk to disrupt the dairy industry. You only have to replace a little over 3% of it. Now, I can hear some of you saying, never, I will never buy any products with fake dairy in it. But here's the problem with that. Nobody's going to ask you. That 65% of dairy products that falls into the direct consumption category, well, sure, you'll still be able to walk up to the dairy case and cast an angry glance at the cashew milk as you defiantly put that quart of half and half in your cart. But that 35% that's going to bankrupt the cow industrial complex, yeah, you probably won't even know about it. The 65% is based on consumer preference. These are business-to-consumer transactions. But that 35%, those protein powders that end up in baby formula, packaged desserts, and sports supplements, those are business-to-business transactions. And those are driven by things like superior quality, consistent supply, and stable pricing, things that traditional dairy just can't match. And it's just going to happen with little fanfare. Nobody's going to ask your permission, and you probably won't even notice. For example, do you remember that time back in the 90s when the cheese industry replaced the enzyme rennet derived from calf stomachs with a molecular analog made in a bioreactor because it was cheaper, better, and more humane and sustainable? Yeah, I didn't get that memo either. But it won't stop there. As prices for that remaining 65% of dairy products start going through the roof, those too will be replaced by nutritionally and environmentally superior products that come from bioreactors instead of cows. See, once you can make molecularly accurate analogs for milk, you can also make cow-free versions of cheese, sour cream, yogurt, and ice cream that taste exactly like the real thing. except that they won't have traces of antibiotics, growth hormones, or other things that find their way into cow milk. And this someday future I'm talking about, well, as I said a minute ago, it's kind of actually already here. Enter Perfect Day Inc. The short story is that a couple of smart guys shared a passion for veganism, molecular biology, and cheese. They understood a few key things. One, milk isn't really that complicated. It's made from just a couple of proteins, fat, vitamins, and water. Two, they understood that microbes could be hacked in order to produce animal proteins without actually using an animal. And three, they figured that they could probably make a pretty good business out of it. Just this month, Perfect Day landed a $300 million Series C fundraise. Last year, they released their first trial product to a curious food industry, 3 pints of ice cream made with their cow-free flora-made milk for $60. They sold out in 1 day. Now, bringing down the price is just a matter of scaling, and scaling is only a matter of money. And Perfect Day is now sitting on a pile of it. And in breaking news, just yesterday as I was writing this, they announced a co-branding agreement with Urgent Foods to sell their flora-made ice cream in retail stores at a much more accessible $5.99 per pint price point. So how is the ice cream? Well, Monica Macy is an executive vice president and chief of staff at the huge U.S. dairy cooperative, the Dairy Farmers of America. She was among those to fork over $60 for that limited edition Perfect Day ice cream last year, and here's what she had to say about it. We sat down in a dairy cooperative headquarters and ate it, and I said, oh, we're screwed, because it tasted just like ice cream. It must have been awkward for her. Perfect Day is adopting an OEM business model. They want to be more of an Intel than an Apple, making their custom-designed proteins available to existing food manufacturers. In fact, they're ahead of schedule, having already achieved an efficiency benchmark that they had originally targeted for 2022. Perfect Day is just one of many startups eager to disrupt every aspect of animal agriculture in the coming years, and it's where the savvy venture capitalists are placing their bets these days. So, to complete the math, we have an industry on the ropes minus 35% of its revenue, and that equals, well, carry the one, bankruptcy. This transition is going to be hard on dairy farmers, but there's no question that the environment will be better off because of this disruption. So will nutrition, food security, and animal welfare. And these aren't just fringe new age ideas we're talking about here. As outlandish as predicting the demise of the industrial dairy industry may seem, it's actually becoming a pretty mainstream idea. So I just thought you'd want to know. There are so many exciting things happening in the world of food tech these days, and I'd love to keep telling you about them. So if you found this video interesting, let me know with a like or a comment, and subscribe to see more of them. So till the next one, this is the Flexitarian Times. I'm Vince. Thanks for watching.